closer to your mic.
Hi, am I audible now? Pleasure to be here. I'm Rini from Loke Capital. Loke is an impact investment fund. By that, what I mean is that we don't only look at the commercial aspect of the deal, which all the other funds over here would look at, but we also invest in companies which create impact on the underserved sections of the society. In layman's terms, if it's a home services company, a tech VC would look at the disruption it's creating in the market. Loke would also have additional lens of looking at it because it will look at the impact through the income generation and the livelihoods that the same company is creating. So that's the basic difference. When we evaluate companies, other than the skills of the entrepreneur and the business idea, we also look at the intent and some kind of alignment. There should be a philosophical alignment with the promoter that he wants to do something where there's inherent impact through its business operations. For example, if it's a dairy company and it's a consumer brand that even we would be interested in looking at, but the back end should be that we should be working with farmers and helping them augment their incomes as well. So front end you have to create commercial returns, but on the back end there is some sort of impact for the underserved sections. So the fund was started in 2006 by Dr. Rajiv Lal, who's the MD and chairman of IDFC Bank, along with Dr. Donald Peck, who was heading the CDC's South Asian portfolio of $1 million. And over the years, we have diversified into other sectors, social infrastructure sectors like healthcare, education, and market linkages. So today, we have investments in 22 companies, out of which we have successfully exited 8 companies. Arguably, we would be one of the best impact funds in terms of the returns that we've generated for our LPs. We are backed by development financial institutions like IFC, CDC, the likes of FMO. We have 2 funds under management which are almost fully deployed, $90 million. And we are in the process of raising our 3rd fund, which we would be closing anytime soon in February or March of this year. Typical ticket size now is between $3 million to $7, $8 million, out of which if more than $6 million, our LPs are happy to co-invest with us. And we look at deals from early stage to late stages, not late, but at least companies which are in their growing stage. And we have 2 offices, one in Delhi, one in Chennai, and a team of around 6-7 investment professionals. Any questions?
How many lives has the best investment?
We're not going to take that question.
I'm shut up now.
What are you looking in a team when you're looking? Impact investment is something, okay, the impact is there, but when you're looking at a team, what qualities are you looking for? As on the entrepreneur and the also what team size should be there? Any criteria set by you?
No, so that is like any other typical VCPE fund. When we are looking at the team, we are looking at the promoters, past background, his execution capabilities, how he's thought through about the idea that he's, you know, pitching to us, whether there is a history already, has the company been operational. So these are the typical criteria. In terms of intent, yeah, we do look at whether, you know, he's trying to just add impact on top of what he's doing by saying that, you know, we'll do some CSR activities, or it should be something inherent in the business model. Like a lot of our investments are in the financial inclusion space. So, you know, the end borrowers over there are people who are getting benefited, like Sequoia mentioned, Ujjivan, so which is again one of our, we've also invested in that company from the early stage. So, typical what other investors also have.
So, just to follow up on that, like you look at the team the same way as a typical VC, but you also look at financial return the same way as a typical VC, or because of the social impact, are you willing to take certain risks that other VCs don't?
So, for example, if another VC is looking at an IRR of 50-60%, we are happy with an IRR less than that, as long as commercial, along with commercial returns, social returns are also generated. So we are pretty flexible on that. We are happy with a lower IRR plus good
about the question on the same thing, but there has to be some financial return before you make any investment.
So of course, we don't invest in non-for-profit or we don't do any grants.
So what I mean is, right now the money is not generated, the business model is there to generate the money. The company is doing what it is doing and it is creating a social impact. But financially they are not generating any money from the model right now.
No, so it's not like we'll only invest in profitable companies. We also take early stage or, you know, growth stage risks. So if we are exiting, we're not saying that we'll only invest in companies which are profitable. When we are exiting, we'll exit to another financial investor when the value of the company has increased. In fact, I forgot to mention, so we do a lot of value-add to our portfolio companies, work very closely with them. So it's not that it has to be today generating. As long as the business makes sense, there are gross margins, the unit economics is making sense, we will invest in the company.
And you do a few things outside of investing, as well, in terms of advisory and things like that, right?
We pretty much do advisory. We have a local foundation which works on with government, which I'm not very comfortable talking about right now. But in terms of our value add, yes, we do get funds from our LPs to invest to give technical assistance to our portfolio companies and also help companies with low fellows. So we do hire for our portfolio companies young graduates who have some relevant work experience and are looking for 12 to 18 months of an extended internship with one of our portfolio companies to help on any particular area, for example IT or HR, to help in capacity building. So that is something that we do.
We also participate in policy intervention to make the segment level for the people.
No, we don't participate actively. We do engage at some level, but not actively.
The question was, do you participate in, do you have the policy intervention? last question. There's someone who had their hand up.
So of the portfolio of companies you have, which company has been able to impact the largest number of lives and how many they were?
The question was, of your portfolio, which has had the largest impact so far?
In terms of lives.
So generally, in terms of scalability, I would say our microfinance companies, because the number of borrowers that have been, the number of people who borrowed from them. But otherwise, if it's an affordable healthcare company, then the number of people who've got their eye tested and they've got, so even that's there. But microfinance.
But what could be that number? Million, 10 million, 100 million?
Not too sure.
1 billion?
Yeah. More than that.
That's India's population.
No, I heard 1 million.
1 billion.
All right, thanks so much.